Hi guys, intro video today for the next multi-video teardown. This huge thing is an old autopilot made under a Sperry license by SFIM in France. So it must be 60s or 70s vintage. And as you can see, it is a big rack with a number of modules. So we will have a look at each one of them. The three in the middle here are three times, are duplicate by the way. But maybe there will be differences between them if they are not same serial number. We have two serial numbers that follow and one older serial number. So it will be interesting to see if there is a difference. So as you can see, they are quite the paint is quite sad, but as it is a collectible item, I will not tinker with the paint. So we will have a look at all the stickers first in this intro video and at the rack by itself. So here is one side for it. Here is the top side with module covers. You can see each module is attached to the rack with a few screws, and there is one or two connectors at the back keeping them in place while connecting them. At the bottom, nothing except a window here. At the front, we have one cover with some trim pots, I believe, and stuff like this inside. And at the back, we have, oops, my air isolator. We have the big connector. So I will now zoom in onto the interesting stickers. So here is the main manufacturer plate. It is SP40 automatic pilot flight control computer made under license of Sperry by SFIM company in France. Serial number is 20213 on this thing. On the side here, are we in the frame? Yes, we have another indication made by SFIM Massy France under license of Sperry Phonics Company, part of Sperry Rand Corporation. In fact, you can find very similar devices made by Sperry, exactly the same layout and such. So it is just local manufacturing, in fact. I believe maybe they did also import most of the pieces from the US because there are quite weird American components in this. Here we have a little modification sticker. So the rack itself has another number, serial number 20006 with some modifications A and B, it seems. On the top, we will have a look at the labels of each module. So the first one here, you cannot see very well, maybe it is a Yao coupler, no, excuse me, trim coupler. Serial number 20063. The next one is the radio coupler. Serial number 20121. Then we have three times the amplifier pulse width. This one is serial number 10417. And the two next ones are matching serial numbers. If the focus can come and the alarm outside can come off, it should be nice. It is 11005 and 11006 serial numbers with two modules. So they were really made at the same time. So I guess the other one on the left here with a different serial number was maybe replaced at some point by replacement part, which is actually older. Here we have where probably all the brains are. It is the signal computer. Serial number 20253. And the last one is the Yao computer. Serial number 10343. So all these modules can be removed individually and will be the subject of a video. But for now, I guess we can have a quick look at the stuff in the front part here. Okay, in fact, we have two panels. So this thing here can be removed with this kind of clips. Should come off like so. Not very easy, but it is coming, it is coming. Okay, oh, there is more stuff that I did believe. What do we have here? We have some kind of a test plug, obviously. We have this PCB filled with resistors. They look like they are some kind of configuration resistors, in fact, to set something. And this PCB is mounted on with a plug, so it looks like I will be able to remove it. I am checking. Here we have yes, one connector to undo and it seems two screws. So let's try it, guys. If I remove this, then this. Then this small plug here, which oddly enough has only one wire coming out. This must be some kind of coupler plug, also grounding or something like this. So these little plugs are really nice quality, but they can break, so you must be careful when you undo them. It looks like we are good to go. I can try to pry off. Yeah, no, we have two little. It is a trick. In fact, the plug here is the same than this one, and there is two little screws that require to be removed, well, lose unscrewed at least, in order to get access to the thing. Not sure, not, there is only one on the left, oddly enough. There we are. It should come. Not sure why it does not come. What do we have here? We have a small nut in here, it seems. It's quite hard. No, there is a screw here. Oui. It is hidden at the bottom. Yes. Okay. Here we are. So, it is a first idea of what will look the stuff inside the modules, in fact. You have here all these wires with four lit shielded relays and this big ass connector here, which has a crack in it. And here at the back, we have the matching female connector, of course, and a bunch of other relays. Behind these plates, we have small transformers. Maybe, yes, you can see the yellow tape here. Here we have a very, very little round thing. Probably a small, some kind of small relay. It is written UTC DOT magnetic shield. And what do we have else? In fact, we have this bottom panel here, but it looks like there is nothing to see in here. So I am checking. There is a long time I didn't take it apart, so I don't remember exactly. Yes, there is nothing. It is just the wire loom going to the into the bottom part of the rack and being distributed to all the modules. Okay, so this concludes this intro for this Sperry Autopilot teardown. In the next videos, we will start. I will remove all the modules and we have a detailed look at the other parts behind here in the rack. Thanks for watching. For now, bye bye. Hi, today I will remove these modules on the Sperry Autopilot computer. So here you cannot use a power screwdriver because the screws are at a very narrow angle and very near of this wall. Luckily enough, I have a long screwdriver, so it will not be too much pain. So I need to undo all these screws, guys. So let's do it. Thank you. Okay, I did remove the screws on each module, so I can lift them. I should be able to lift them. I hope I will be able to lift them at least. Yes. Again, these pretty hardcore connectors. So each module is made of a two-parts case. The top part is held in place with some screws, either on the side, on the top, or on the side here. The bottom part with fasteners. And around it, there is some kind of PVC tape to make a seal. Do not know how original it is. I have another Sperry item with aluminium tape as a use as a seal. So here is the connector for it. And as you can see, it seems to be quite serious. EV gold plating, glass pass-through for the pins. So this is the first part, first module, your computer. Let me put this aside. Here, a big one. With, as you can see, the identical connector. It is the signal computer. So I will directly put this in storage. Next one, the amplifier pulse wave, and they are all the three the same. The two last modules. So it is now very light, but this thing is not incredibly heavy. Anyway, so again a big connector. It is the radio coupler. And this one, which is a little smaller, I did just forget to undo the screws. There we are. This one has the plug in the other direction, and it is the trim coupler. Okay. Now we will have a look at this this part here and here, because if I remember correctly, in fact, I did never undo these covers. And it seems it is just a matter of removing a few screws. By the way, I did just find a washer. So, let me try to undo this. There is the screw at the end here to remove also. No screws on the bottom. Good enough. And one more screw here for this part. It looks like it may come off this. There is some kind of a slider thing here. Not sure if you can see. So here is the main wire harness, as you can see, very beautifully made. And there is this fork things here to keep it in place. Quite a thick wire loom. As you can see, now I will remove this top this end plate. it seems it is just a deal of 4 screws. So here you have the big, better like this maybe, the big connector to connect to the aircraft harness. So you can see there is no coax in this thing, only straight pins and pretty thick pins. So here we are. So here is the back side of this plug. As you can see, pretty strong thing. And here on this plate we have more little shielded relays on a metal bracket with some capacitors made by Goodman Company. On the relays I cannot see the brand because it is hidden. So here now this thing is completely loose because yes, there is a rivet here which is broken, it seems. Okay, so we'll it will be a good opportunity to clean a little bit at the bottom. Here, as you can see, it is quite dirty. I did never clean this part, I think. And I will put it back together. And in the next video, we will start having a look at the modules. So it is interesting. And just see, it seems the front part here, the wall front panel, there are 6 screws you can remove and it could allow to remove the entire front panel. So I guess you should be able to remove this panel, then unroute this thing through this hole, then also this thing and the end connector here, if you can take it more or less apart, maybe you can feed everything through this hole. Yes, in fact it is not sure because we have or maybe there's just screws to keep in place the struts at the other side of the cover. And these are for the handle, yes. So anyway, yes, this all must allow to feed the harness through it. Okay, so I will clean it and put it back together. Thanks for watching. Hi, we continue the teardown of the Sperry SP40 autopilot. So today the trim coupler, it is the smallest plug-in module. So I will remove the sticky tape here all around. And remove the screws. So I do not remember exactly what we have in each module, but I know it is quite impressive. So you can see this module, the case is in pretty bad condition on this side. It is oxidized. So, yes, I will also undo the bottom cover. Here we are. What do we have, guys? So, first side, a bunch of relays, Dutch, Litch, on this plate. A little potted module here. You can see a nice quality of aluminium here. And on the other side, we have some wirings, some little trim pots here and here, and capacitors, and all these pins. So you can see there is an unpopulated space here. So I guess I will need to remove more screws in order to have a look. This one will be much more convenient. So yes, we have four screws. Probably I did already undo them previously because they are really not difficult to remove. And here, yes, we have a bunch of potted modules. As you can see, so potted electronics with a model number on, written on each of them and a serial number here. So you can see it is made by SFIM and each module has its own serial number. It is a really hard epoxy. I have no, sadly, I have no X-ray machine handy to X-ray them and have a look inside. I guess they are little printed circuits with discrete amplifiers and things like this. Transistor electronics, probably. So we have three relay drivers, two sensors and one trim monitor sensor. Here, this thing is probably a transformer, I guess, maybe, not sure. And this may be a dead code. I'm checking if I have other ones. So here you have screws holding the relays in place. Two per, for each relay. Do we have stamps or something? Maybe here we have 67 written. And this may be 66. So yes, it may be late 60s. We will probably find more, more indications in the other modules. So this one is a simple one, but if I remember correctly, we will meet again this kind of potted modules in the other parts. So this was the first one. I would really like to see what there is inside this, but I cannot take them apart with no damage. I would like to find another scrap, completely junk autopilot of this kind, and then take it apart completely for salvaging the relays and such, but they are becoming quite hard to find. This one I did got it from contact. I did find on eBay, but it was a direct sell to me. And if I remember correctly, it was not far from 100 euros, so it was not cheap. But there was at least 20 euros of shipping in it, also. Okay, and you can see this really, really nice connector here. EV gold plating on it. Quite impressive. So I will put this back together, and in the next video we will see another module. Hi, next part in the teardown of the big Sperry autopilot. The Yao coupler, or no, it's a Yao computer. I did already remove the screw to save some time, and I did just notice, even if it is made in France, it is Imperial screws. So just remove the old nasty sticky tape. I have sticky fingers now. So what do we have? We have some electromechanical goodness, it seems. And this part will not come off. It looks, I need to remove more screws. So let me remove quickly the screws. So So we have here some electromechanical computing, it seems, with synchro resolvers, synchro generators, synchro resolvers. Must be doing some computing of some flavor. I will check if I can find any data on this system on the web, but usually it is not easy. So here we are. So we can see this big mechanical assembly. It is probably just a gear, a set of gears connecting together the different parts. We have more relays here. There is a built-in connector here, so it seems this can be removed and replaced. But I do not know if I will open it because I do not want to mess with it. And yes, indeed, we can see the insides here. There is a little hole. And I can see gears. So it is just gears connecting the parts together. This may be a electromechanical clutch, probably. So what do we have? We have something synchro. Pitch synchro, maybe. Oh, clutch synchro. It is UTCH, but I can see the first letter. And we can see it is a two-parts device. Here we have a Weston motor. And here we have probably a synchro transformer or synchro resolver. We have, so it is called a servo assembly. Serial number 466. So what do we have else? In fact, not much. We have two modules here. Power supply and instrumentation or inst something, servo amplifier. We have a nice Sprague shielded body capacitor here. And we have two Texas Instruments transistors. They are 2N1050A, date code of 1968. So yes, it is late 60s. And by the way, it seems this transistor has a very weird package, because look here, you have a golden screw, probably keeping the transistor case in place, so it must be part of the transistor case. And back here, we can see the three golden legs for the transistor. And of course, always the nice wirings. A few more parts back here, but nothing special. You can see the frame of this part, or the folded aluminium parts. And of course, the most interesting part is this. Quite impressive, but I think there is another one, maybe one of the other modules, or maybe I am confusing with something else, not sure. We will see anyway. So, thanks for watching. Bye bye. Today we will have a look at not one but two modules from the Sperry Autopilot, because there are similar modules with different batch of serial numbers. This one is the number 10417 and here 11005. It will allow to see if there is any difference or if they are completely identical. So this one has an old bit of nasty sticky tape as always. So it is mostly empty, this thing. So this one is the older one. we have an hidden screw here at the back. It is very, very convenient, of course. Thanks. Very easy to reach. And of course, the best thing to match with an hidden screw is a second hidden screw. This should be good now. Yes, so here is the bottom of the case. You can see the welds here. Quite nice. And here is what we have. So in fact, not much. We have, well, not much. Only half of the volume is taken by things, but still it is still interesting. We have more potting modules. Power supply. Here, number. Serial number 007 here, and it does not tell what it is. We have quad eject in a bright orange module. We have DEM. We have sweep and compare. We have driver, and we have mystery erased thing. Okay, so here one trim pot. And I think the most interesting thing here, so at the back here we have radio noise filters also, two of them, so as they will probably be the same, I will not bother removing the back part of this one. And I think the most interesting thing here are these two packages which seem to be, yes, they are transistors. In one of the most unusual packages I have ever seen. Really, I don't think I did ever see it elsewhere. I do not know the name of this thing. The reference is KM7001. And the manufacturer logo is a K in a square with a thick bottom line. It is all what I can say. They are transistors, yes. So we will have a look at the newer version in order to see if there is any difference or not. So it pulls off the same kind. So first difference, you can see this power diodes. The glass is not the same, as they have the same number, 1N2995B. Yes, but they are not the same manufacturer, it seems. This must be a US made one, and this are maybe European made. So apart from that, well, it looks pretty similar. And on the other side, it is, yes, mostly the same. These diodes are not exactly identical. So the paths are a little bit different. In fact, the transistors here are not the same reference, but it is erased. This components here, resistor or whatever, are bigger on the newer one. This capacitor is not the same. Here it is a shitty West German electrolytic capacitor. This is really a piece of shit. If you have an item with such things, you want to replace them because they fail very, very well. This orange or yellow chemical capacitors are really bad. And the modules are exactly the same, so we know this one is a preamp now. Here we have a little bit of a difference in the package color. And this module here is not exactly the same finish. And the brand on it is not the same. It is written EMP with only one number. But here it is written something. SBEA maybe, or something like this, with more information. So it is not completely identical. It is interesting. Okay, the wiring seems to be done almost same color code, you can see between the two, same colors of wire, same place. Okay, so I will put them back together. Thanks for watching. Bye bye. Hi guys, we continue the teardown of Sperry SFIM autopilot. Today the radio coupler module. So I guess maybe it is for coupling the autopilot to radio navigation system. Maybe. By the way, I did find not any information on the web about this autopilot. The only results that pop up are my own website, where I did publish some photos of it a long time ago. And a few websites try to sell the service manual, but it is not far from $100. Apart from that, it is impossible to get any information. So this module is a bigger one, as you can see. I did already remove a few screws to save time. So this is really junk now. So what do we have in here? This module is constructed differently from the others. As you can see, we have four sides and stuff in the middle. Luckily enough, there is a hinge here. And it will be possible to pop it open and see what there is in the middle. So here, first at this end, the big connector. And a bunch of relays. This box, I do not know what it is, but there is only four connections on it, it seems. Here we have one or two transformers. Okay, so on this side, we have a bunch of resistors on a soldering post with Teflon insulated ones. We have capacitors, one golden leg transistor. And as you can see, there is a few unpopulated holders here. Not sure why it is for. Maybe it is for extra parts which are not populated here. On this side, we have lots of capacitors. They must be... this one are sealed with glass hands. So this must be good ones. This must be just electrochemical caps. But not polarized, it seems. We have here more transistors. These are mysterious parts. It is written 1000 ohms. So maybe they are just resistors, precision resistors. Yes, plus or minus 1%. And here we have what seems to be four glass body diodes in an aluminum block, maybe for thermal coupling. On this side, more of the same stuff, exactly the same stuff. And here, nothing, except we can see a bunch of relays. So, now I will open this, flip open this part. It is with undoing this screw. So here we are, as you can see, inside quite a bunch of wires.
and a few more transistors. This round black things must be relays, I believe. Some kind of relays. Yes. And here we have this weird black modules, which are completely mysterious. You have numbers written on it for you, if you want to Google them, but... So there are, each of them have three sets of wires going out. And it seems it is filled with some white compound as silicon or something like this. Silicon compound. So there must be full of this. So. And here you can see more wires in the bottom with a row of relays. Some more capacitors here, and well, it is all for this module, which does some kind of radio coupling. So in the next video, we will have a look at the most interesting modules of them. Thanks for watching. Bye bye. Hi, last part of Sperry Autopilot teardown with this signal computer box, which probably computes the signal, and is probably the earth of Autopilot, processing all the signals from the other modules. But no microprocessor here, no logic stuff, only analog stuff. So as you can see, it is very very full, and we have one of our servo mechanics module, but this one seems easy to reach and is fitted with a connector, so I think I will be able to remove it. And we will be able to have a look in it. So first, and here you have three cards, kind of modules, which can be disconnected. So we will do it for sure. So first, walk around of the thing. We have several of these gray boxes, which are called MagMod Magnetic Modulator. Made by General Magnetics Incorporated in Bloomfield, New Jersey. The patent number is 2758162, type number 1IMM526-4. So it would be interesting to search the patent in order to try to understand what they are. And by the way, it is written here on the side, this is a patented circuit. So there must be some magic going in this. Here you have the bottom side of one of them. You can see it is a glass pass-through with a bunch of contacts, like you have on some relays. So apart from this, you can see all the wires and such, not very interesting. Components here, passive components, maybe diodes here. Here an insanely long capacitor, rated at 200 microfarads, 25 volts. And here there is some kind of a filler thing in a pocket light or something like this. Some transistor here with General Electric logo at the end. Other side, opposite side, almost the same thing. One more of these black shaded relays. More transistors with golden legs. And one other bottom side of a magnetic modulator. Here in the gap between the two parts, we have some relays, which are mounted at an angle, as you can see. in order to make some space for this connector bracket. And we have some very regular stuff as transformers. So what I will do now, I will remove this part on these three cards in order to have a better look at them. The thing is now in modules, so it will be easier to have a look at them. So first, here is the main the frame for it with the connectors and just some wirings, relays and the transformer as I did show just before. You can see the very nice quality of the metalwork here. The golden connector, of course, and seems here we have, yes, it is a handwritten serial number for the thing. It is the same than the serial number on the cover. So, this module here, as you can see, we have more of these potted modules, like we did have in the other modules. Some 2N1050A Texas Instrument transistors. And relays, of course, and this gray module, it looks very much like the mag modulator, as you can see, but it is not written the same thing. It is written SBAA V3, it is a town in France, with a serial number. And here there is nothing about a patent. Nice logo here on the side, looks like you can see it very well. So on this part, we have a nice little trimmer here in with anodized aluminium body. So if you can see it, it's really cute. And so the magnetic modulator, one of them, with date code, 30th December of 1969. And this is a patented circuit. Do not copy it. Not sure if a patent will show any technical information about this. If I find any information, I will put a link in the video description. Nice writings here for the numbers of the pinouts and things like this. Silk screen writing, probably. Something like this. So the last of electronic modules here. We have one bigger magnetic modulator. Still made by General Magnetics. And as you can see, there is a nice schematics here. Seems it is some kind of servo control. So this is a big one, a smaller one here, and of course this is a patented circuit. Not sure who will take apart over expensive at the time autopilot and try to crack apart one of these things to see the contents and copy it, but well, here we have something interesting. It is some kind of a disk component, as can be anything in fact. Can be a capacitor, can be a temperature sensor, or something like this. With very long legs, and as you can see, it is just flying in the breeze. It does not look very aircraft grade. It's kind of mounting, because if you look at the other parts, maybe not this one, but all the other parts are very well stuck in place, not this. It is quite weird. Nice LCC capacitor here, probably this one is a very good quality. And last part, the what is this? Servo assembly. We had another one in one of the first modules I did show you. Sadly, I cannot remove this bottom plate because, as you can see, there are ball bearings. And I have a feeling if I remove the plate, it will be impossible to realign properly all the shaft in the bearings. It did already happen with the previous stuff, so here we have a Weston motor generator made by Weston Instruments, 26 volt inputs, 9500 RPMs. And here we have Clifton Precision Products control transformer. So for getting some feedback probably. I guess this is just a magnetic clutch. Yes, we have two wires going to it. So it is probably a brake to block everything in place when needed. Okay, so I will try to put all this back together. I hope you did enjoy this video series about this Sperry autopilot. I have some other big avionics devices I still need to do videos about, but sadly it is more lack of time really to do something good and interesting. Because it is quite time consuming, this. But by the way, these parts are really, really pretty. So, thanks for watching for now, and see you soon. Bye bye.